What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven and Stereo, and in today's video we are going to be checking out Lil Nas X doing That's What I Want live on BBC Radio 1. I'm so excited to check this out because I've been obsessed with this song since we actually did the official music video reaction. I think it's just a wonderful blend of old school pop punk meets a new school approach, and you get a little bit of Lil Nas X. Well, I say a little bit. You get a lot of Lil Nas X happening all over this track, and I think there's something really beautiful about that. So I'm really excited to see him check this out live. Now, I am still going to be doing the Montero album reaction. I'm in the process of adopting a new rescue dog, and the place that I'm trying to adopt from is very strict, so there's been a lot of things kind of happening in the background for approval, and it's been a little bit stressful, but he's finally coming home today, so hopefully he adjusts well, everything is good with the other kitties and puppy, and if all that is good, I will have more time, I will be able to do this album reaction finally. So I am so sorry for the lag, but I promise I'm so stoked to check the album out. With all that out of the way, just, you know, giving you guys a little update on my life, let's do That's What I Want in the live lounge.
BBC Radio 1.
Wait, can we talk about the set design really quick? Like, this is so sick. And also, I don't know how many tracks he did on this day, but I just love that this kind of like setup actually reminds me a lot of kind of the vibe I get from this song. Like, I don't know why. It feels very like upbeat, even though the track itself is pretty sad. Look at him.
Need a boy who can cuddle with me all night. Keep me warm, let me long, be my sunlight.
Woo!
Tell me lies, we can argue, we can fight. Yeah, we did it before, but we'll do it tonight.
Wait, I just love how much he gets into this. Like, I think one of my favorite things is, you know, a lot of people were writing Lil Nas X off right from the beginning. And what I love is that he's seeing a lot of success with this recent album. He's getting a lot of press. I know he just did SNL, which, by the way, I did watch his cover of Call Me By Your Name. Not his cover, but his performance of Call Me By Your Name on SNL Live. So fucking sick. But what I love is even in moments like this, like, he's really feeling it. You can see the passion coming to life. And I'm just glad that he's finally getting more recognition.
But we'll do it tonight. That afro black boy with the gold teeth.
Hey,
dark skin looking at me like you know me. I wonder if you got the G or the B. Let me find out and see. Coming over to me. These days I'm way too lonely. I'm missing out, I know. These days I'm way too alone. But I'm not forgiving, love away. But I want.
Yes. Wait, he sounds fucking great with this right now. Like, there is just a level of emotion he's bringing to this that lets you know that he really means this shit, but at the same time, he's got a really great way of delivering that message loud and fucking clear. I love that little bit of higher range he gets into that chorus. So good.
I'm missing out, I know. These days I'm way too alone, but I'm not forgiving, love away, but
let's go! Wait, I'm fucking obsessed. God, I'm obsessed with the set.
Need an adversary to my down and rarity. Tell me that's life when I'm stressing.
Hey,
you'll be okay and everything's all right. Let me get nothing because I'm not.
You know, you really think about the lyrics of the song. I know we talked about this in the official video, but it's really sad. Like, Lil Nas X is literally just saying, like, I just want someone around who's going to give me love, who's going to comfort me when times are tough, who's going to be my partner and my ride or die. Like, that's all everybody really wants. When you think about what love really is, love is just having that best friend that's going to be there for you no matter what, that you feel emotionally connected to. And that's all Lil Nas X is singing about. And I just love, especially in those higher notes he gets in this chorus, he's really trying to shout it to the world, like, this is what I want. Hey,
you be okay and everything's all right. Let me in nothing because I'm not wanting anything but you loving your body and a little bit of your brain. These days I'm way too lonely. I'm missing out, I know.
Let's go! Woo! Oh fuck, those so harmonies!
Me, I need someone who needs me.
I am like, I'm literally so energized right now after watching that. It's just been so cool to see Lil Nas X kind of like showing to everyone who doubted him, not only am I still here in this music thing, but I'm fucking thriving. And it's so cool because, you know, when Old Town Road came out, I feel like there were a lot of people, I mean, a lot of people that really wrote him off. And I remember even when his first EP dropped, he had a couple cool features and stuff on there, but I remember people were still like, oh, this is not what we were expecting. We want more from him. You know, everybody has an opinion. That's fine. But there were a lot of negative opinions going towards his way, especially when he came out and then you saw like more of the music industry like fucking divide about Lil Nas X. And what I love so much about him is that he stayed persistent. He knew what he wanted. He knew what he wanted to make. He knew the life he wanted to live. And to see him put out an album that is getting received so well, to see him have a couple of really amazing singles right off the bat, to see him hosting SNL, like, I see all these things coming to life for him, and it just gets me so excited because when you watch this live performance right here, yes, I love the music video. I think that you definitely get even more meaning out of this song when you can see some of the visual representations that kind of inspired the reasons that he wrote this song. I think it's actually really deep. You might not hear that just by listening to this instrumental that's, you know, kind of reminds me a little bit of Hey Ya from Outkast. Like, you may not see that really happening here. However, when you watch that video, you really get to see that come to life. Now, him in this performance, this is actually one of the coolest things I've ever seen from him. First and foremost, I think that the set design in this was really perfect. I think it just really matches and caters to the style that he's creating, that visual representation of the songs that he's making. I think that's a really important thing. But just to see him standing there, you've got the butterfly, you've got the flowers going down the mic stand, and there's a level of confidence that he has in himself where that acceptance of his music is finally becoming a real reality for him. And I love that he's continuing to make what he wants. Now, I don't know what all this album dives into. Obviously, I've had to avoid this album so hard. It's been very difficult because it comes up on Apple Music for me to listen to all the time. And I won't do it because I would do a reaction. But him performing this song here shows a level of emotion that really gets me stoked to see what else he does in that album. I just love seeing him in this moment, standing there with that confidence, having these moments where he's got these high notes that come to life and really bring that chorus into, I think, the perfection that it is. One thing you have to think about with the song is while it does give me a little bit of the vibes to Hey Ya, which, by the way, if you ever look at the lyrics of that song, I'm not trying to mansplain this to you. I just found this out like a year ago. But that song's actually super fucking depressing. And it kind of reminds me of this song as well, where you've got that upbeat instrumental that's happening in the back. You've got Lil Nas X kind of coming to life. But the lyrics are really sad and the message is really sad. And it's really just a cry for help of, you know, just wanting someone to love you unconditionally, wanting someone to be there for you, wanting someone to support you. And if you don't believe that he means that shit, just listen to this chorus over and over again. When he switches from that lower tone, because he's got that really deep voice, but when he switches from that to that high range, you definitely get all the feels of this track. So I fucking love this. I'm stoked to do the album. I hope you guys are excited for it. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think of this performance. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.